Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Elda, and you already know how we get down. If this is your first time tuning in, I welcome you with love, hugs, and kisses. Mwah. But in order for you to be my cousin, right, in order for you to be my cousin, all right, I need you to hit the subscribe button, okay, and hit that bell, okay, then light up the comment section with hashtag DotCousinGang. You already know, baby. And those of you that's been rocking with your girl, what's up, Fummy? What's up, Kozo? You already know, baby. You already know how we get down. We be like, welcome back. Bang. Hey, bang. Bang. Hey. So, listen, y'all. We are hungry, okay? When I say hungry, I am hungry. So, we're about to go get something to eat because I'm hungry, all right? Y'all, family, we gonna have a conversation, cuzzo. Cuzzo, we gonna have a conversation today, okay? Cause y'all know me. I be with the deep conversations, okay? I be with the deep conversations. All right, so y'all, today kind of turned into a self-care day because, like I said, you know, anybody that knows me knows I have a heart of servitude. I love very strongly and I'm very compassionate, okay? But today has turned into a self-love day, okay? So look, fresh flowers. So you guys already know I love me some flamowers, okay? And then I got some for my bedroom, but this is a smaller. Isn't it so pretty? Like, oh my gosh. And y'all know I love me some candles. So with that being said, all right, y'all, we are headed to go get something to eat. I'm still trying to figure out what I want to eat. Most likely, I'm gonna hit up the hibachi spot for the lunch special, okay? And yeah, so let's get in the car so we can, ooh, I'm dark, y'all. Let's get in the car, y'all, so we can have this conversation. Cause as you can see by the title, baby, when I say I'm becoming an introvert, baby, I'm just like, Lord, keep me. So, no malice, no hate, no any of that goes into my heart, but let's get it. All right, cuzzo, so, yeah. Listen, y'all, when I say y'all cuzzo so hurt, bruh, I'm so hurt. Like, words cannot describe how I'm feeling. But I find myself really thanking God for being a keeper. For being a keeper, even when you don't want to be kept. You know what I'm saying? And those of you that know me over the years, you know that I am a lovable person. I may have my attitudes. Okay, that's only when I'm hungry. Don't judge me. Judge your big toe. That's only when I am hungry, I say. Okay, praise the Lord, somebody. Okay, but y'all know me. When I rock with you, I rock with you. That's and that's on God. Like, anybody will tell you, when I rock with you, I rock with you. Through thick and through thin. Whether it's in a relationship or a friendship, like, once I say I rock with you, I rock with you. When I say I support you, I support you. When I say I believe in you, I believe in you. But I have one rule, guys. Just don't lie to me. Just don't lie. Hold on, y'all. Somebody calling me. Yeah, so I only have one rule, y'all. And that's don't lie to me. Keep it 100. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not judgmental. I'm not one of those people that's gonna really beat you down. But I'm also one of those friends that's gonna tell you, not even only friends, like, if we have any type of friendship, relationship, whatever, I'm also one of those people that ain't gonna sugarcoat nothing. Cause I'm gonna tell you, I ain't Willy Wonka, baby. I ain't Willy Wonka. I ain't got no sugar here for you. But I'm gonna tell you how it is, and I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. You get what I'm saying? Because I expect the same in return. But what I've come to learn over the years, and I was reminded recently, you know, with certain events. All right, y'all know what I went through with the whole hospital situation, and you know, like it has revealed a lot to me. You know, and some other events have taken place. So it has revealed a lot to me. And it's like sometimes what you expect from that person, they may not be able to deliver. Okay? Or how you treat the person, you know, like you just got to see people for who they are and where they at, and guard yourself and govern yourself accordingly in that relationship, okay? Whether it's a friendship or, you know, shabubu or whatever. Y'all, because, honey, like I said, communication. Listen, we're going to change that. Communication is key. But it's also understanding. Understanding is key, because you can communicate with the person. You can whatever form of communication works for you, you can do all of that. But if that person don't got no understanding, honey boo boo, sir, ma'am, listen, it's just too much. So with these recent events, you know, it has hurt me. It has hurt me, okay? And like I said, I bless God for who He is in my life, for real. Because if it wasn't for God, these scenarios, these situations that has taken place over the time, y'all, if this was the BC elder, it wouldn't be pretty. It just wouldn't be pretty. But I just bless God that I'm in a place where, despite it all, I'm still able to love. I'm able to forgive. You know what I'm saying? And even minister to that individual. You understand? So it's just like, if it wasn't for God. So I may have some non-believers in here. But, you know, take what you need. Because, you know, I'm not going to force God on you. But, you know, take what you need from this chat. But you, as an individual, me as a person, I had to get to a place, what's called maturity, which a lot of us lack, okay? I had to get to a place of maturity, okay? And I've come to a place over the years, okay, where I do not allow, how can I put this? I have my emotions under control. So how you would expect me to react to a situation, I normally, 9 times out of 10, you're not going to get that reaction. Okay? So it's like, I really sit and I really analyze and I really break it down. Like, I break down the whole scenario. I don't just be so quick to react. Okay? And so, yeah, sometimes I do have to catch myself, y'all. Sometimes I really do have to catch myself, because you want to be like, what? Or you want to be like, duh, you know, just start foaming out the mouth. But I've learned the power of my words as well. I learned the power of my words as well. And y'all know me as a low key preacher. Even though I be hitting that Jonah sometimes. As a low-key preacher, when you know the power of your words, you refrain from saying certain things. You refrain from thinking certain ways. You get what I'm saying? But as I was saying, I begin to break down the situation. So I don't only look at it from my perspective, but I try my best. And somebody, I know somebody like, girl, you better than me. You better than me. I'm going to say what I got to say, or I'm going to react how I'm going to react, and I'm just going to be great. But I've learned to not only look at it from my perspective, but I try to understand the headspace that that individual who has hurt me. I try to understand their headspace. I try to understand what was going on at the time. And, you know, and all of that has to do also with discernment, you know, and being in tune with God. Because, listen, when I ask God to show me something, he gonna show me. That's why I say, don't lie to me. Don't lie to praying people. Just don't. If you know that person be in their closet, and you know that person talk to God, okay? And you know that person have a relationship with God, don't lie. Just don't. Just don't. Save yourself the headache. Y'all, I'm trying to park, and I'm about to back this bad boy in. Yeah, so when you know that individual has just don't lie, because you save yourself the time, you save yourself the headache. You get what I'm saying? So with that being said, y'all, I was lied to, and it hurt my feelings tremendously, because when I say, once again, when I say I rock with you, I rock with you. When I say I got you, I got you. I strive to be a woman of my word. And if I feel like I am not able to deliver in any capacity, I'm going to communicate with you and let you know I said this, but I am not able to deliver. So can we, and then we come to a common ground. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm a loyal friend. You know what I'm saying? And if we're in a intimate relationship, I only date men. If we are in an intimate relationship, then you have a loyal partner. You get what I'm saying? So it's just like, I take these things very seriously. I take any relationship, any connection I have with somebody, I take it seriously. I respect it. I value it. And whatever, because if I don't find any value in that relationship, then I'm not going to continue to have that. Or, you know, I'm just going to cut it off. Because, like I said, when you come to a place of maturity, when you come to a healing place, when you've come up out of a dark place, I'm not going to connect myself with somebody who's going to bring me back to that place. I will cut you off so quick. I'll say a prayer for you, but I'll cut you off so quick. Because, listen, if you know my story, all right, I've opened up about depression. You get what I'm saying? So if you know my story and you know what I've been through, then you know certain things. I'm just not going to watch them call it. But that compassion, that forgiving heart, don't take advantage of that. Don't take advantage of my loving heart. Don't do that. Because if you want to see a different side of me, baby, don't do that. Be real with yourself. How can you be real with me if you're not even real with yourself? But y'all, that's my rant. Okay, that is my rant. I am hurt. I haven't done a closet confessions in reference to it yet. I probably won't, depending on how everything goes. Or it might come out later down the line. Like I said, I've forgiven this individual. I still love them the same. My perspective of them haven't shifted. I just understand that they are in a place. They are in a place right now where it's like you have no choice but to face the music. And when you're in such a place, you don't know how you're going to react. You don't know how you're going to treat people. I don't even say how to treat people. You just don't know, because everybody's reaction is different. Everybody deal with pressure in different ways. But, you know, so it's just like I said, I love you. If you watch this, I want you to know I love you. And I'm praying for you. I'm praying that you come up out of that place, that dark place. I'm praying for your healing. I'm praying that you come out of confusion. I'm praying that the Lord order your steps. I speak life over you in the name of Jesus, because I just want you to be reminded that you are transitioning. You are transitioning. This is not your final destination. You are transitioning. You are transitioning. So I need you to get up out of your thoughts, okay? As an overthinker, because you are an overthinker. So as an overthinker, I don't want you to play on your thoughts or be consumed by your thoughts, okay? But you're not going to stay in this place, and things will get better. Things will get better for you. Yes, it will. Because my God is not man, neither is he the son of man. Shall he repent? Hath he said it? Shall he not do it? Or hath he spoken it? Shall he not make it good? So I know that the God that I serve, and you know the God that you serve, okay? So I am praying for you. I am praying for you. But y'all, I don't know who may be watching, or who may be hurt, or who is healing, or who is, you know, dealing with a situation they just don't know what to do, where they feel conflicted. Listen, I pray the clarity. I pray for clarity for you now in the name of Jesus. I pray for I speak discernment in the name of Jesus. I speak, you know, I bind up any mental battles for you. All right, be real. You got to look at the bigger picture. Look at the bigger picture. Do not allow, because at the end of the day, it doesn't mean that you're going to stay in this place, okay? It doesn't mean that you're going to stay in this place, and neither does it mean that this situation is going to happen for a long time. It doesn't mean that. You get what I'm saying? It's just what is occurring at the moment, at the moment, at the moment. So what am I saying? Do not allow your at the moment emotions cause you to make a permanent decision. I need you to sit. I need you to evaluate. I need you to break down, and I need you to be vulnerable with God for my believers, for those, you know, that be, you know, that be shabbat with me. Praise you, Jesus. Listen, I need you to get into the presence of God so that God can show you, so that God can show you. Because it is funny, before I went through this, I feel like crying. Before I went through this, I remember God telling me, I'm increasing your capacity, because God knew what I was getting ready to go through. And y'all, when everything blew up, I was in the middle of fasting, okay? Now imagine if I was not obedient to the voice of God. Imagine if I was not, if I didn't yield and I didn't fast. Like I said, it would have been a whole different reaction. It would have been a whole different reaction. But I am still in a place where I'm just like, you know what, God? If it is your will, let your will be done. Because at the end of the day, no matter what, Elder Aim is going to be good. And that's on God. You feel what I'm saying? So, and like I said, I had to, and when you're going through it, be careful. You have to guard your heart. So you have to pray against bitterness. You have to pray against resentment. You have to pray against anger. You have to pray against these things so that they do not seep into your heart or take root in your heart. Because at the end of the day, no matter what you go through with people, they still are the child of God. They still have to report to God. But guess what? God is holding you accountable to your actions. God is holding you accountable to your verbiage. God is holding you accountable to your thoughts. Now, this is coming from a place of maturity, y'all. This is coming for a place of maturity. A lot of people may not be able to say what I'm saying. A lot of people may not be able to handle the situation how I'm handling the situation. But one thing for sure, this situation ain't gonna take me out. No, it's not. But I felt like, I told y'all I'd be preaching, okay? But I made it. And we about to go eat. What time is it? Yeah. We about to go eat because, baby, I'm just like, I just hate this. This whole mask stuff, guys, I'm over it. I'm over it. So, with that being said, today. You know, I normally do my confessions in the closet, but it's gonna be retail therapy and confessions today, okay? I gotta get my earrings fixed. So I'm wearing the earrings that Bae had got me for my birthday, along with my bracelet. But yeah. I'm just waiting to order. Anybody, I don't mind sitting alone, y'all. I really don't. Well, I already know what I want to eat. Not drinking. I'm not drinking because we're getting ready to go on a sabbatical and getting ready to detox and fast. So if you want to join me, make sure you're following me on Instagram, because I am going to talk about it. And I'm also going on a financial fast. Y'all, that's going to be like epic. That's going to be like epic. So, but I finally found a sushi that I like. You can give me water, please. So, yeah. So let me find out the name of this sushi, because I have to call my friend who I went to lunch with, who made me try it. So, but I'll see y'all when our cook gets here. Look at the textures. Let's see.
Okay, you wanna be on fire? Ready? Fire? Ah, do it.
And that's how I eat lunch. And that's how I eat lunch, y'all. So.
You have filet mignon? No fried rice.
No fried, just white rice. Thank you.
This time you have a steak and shrimp.
Yes, guys, I do.
You have too. Only shrimp.
Just ask me instead of just staring at me.
No. Like, you have steak and chicken. Yes. And you have chicken.
So let's go ahead and eat. Praise the Lord.
One double. Right here, yummy.
Isn't that so? Thank you. All right, y'all. So we ready to eat. As I gather my thoughts and so what I said earlier. So get ready to eat. I love y'all. I'll holler at y'all when we get to the mall. All right, y'all. I had to go home. I changed, switched my wig. Say hello to Stacy, honey. But I got my Humble and Bougie shirt, so make sure y'all click the link in the bio okay, and get your humble and bougie, because we humble and bougie, baby. But y'all, life is so beautiful. Life is beautiful. We need to stop underestimating prayer, okay? We need to stop underestimating prayer and and understand that we serve a mighty God, okay? Because won't he do it? Won't he do it? But, so I change. I'm about to pull up on my sister, my good friend. They have an event today. I'm trying to debate if I wanted to vlog or not a little bit of it. It's called Safe Zone. So if you are not following them on Instagram, please be sure to do so, because they are very big on depression, you know, mental health awareness, you know what I'm saying? And she's always doing events, always doing giveaways. She is truly a woman that pours back into the community. She pours into the community. All right, so be sure to follow them. Are You Okay with Six Wives? And y'all can see it down here, right? Or you can click the link in the description box to follow them. All right, I'm gonna bring my camera just in case we do vlog a little bit, but then after that, I'm finna run to the mall real quick, and then the girls hit me up. They want to come over for a girls' night, so